In this illustration, we will be calculating the force on a tube ejecting a liquid. Here the figure shows a tank of which side wall is having an attached narrowing tube of which cross-sectional area decreases from S1 to S2. And we are required to find the horizontal force acting on the tube due to ejection of the liquid. So in this situation, first thing we can directly write down as the tube is at a depth H below the open surface of the liquid. Here we can directly write down that the ejection velocity of liquid is, the ejection velocity we can directly write down, this will be root 2gh. And if we talk about this tube here, we can redraw the enlarged view of this tube, where we can consider if this cross sectional area is S1, this is S2. Here the radius is B, and here we consider radius to be A. And here liquid is coming out with the velocity V, which is given as root 2gh. And this can be written as V2, which is coming out over here from the cross sectional area S2. Now, if at a distance x inside the tube, we consider a small elemental section, which is of width dx, and its radius if we consider as r, then we can write the radius of elemental ring, or we can also call it a strip, considered as shown is given as, this radius can be given as r, as it is varying linearly from B to A. We can write it B plus B minus A by L times x. As we have got the velocity, we have got the radius of the section, we can find out the velocity of fluid at the section. So we can write velocity of liquid at elemental section is, this we can calculate by continuity equation applied between this point and this point. Here we can write V pi r square should be equals to V2 pi b square. So this will give us the value of V as pi b square multiplied by root 2gh divided by pi r square. R we already calculated. Now using Bernoulli's theorem, at element and S2, we get, if at element and S2 we apply Bernoulli's theorem, here we can see at S2 pressure is say P plus kinetic energy of fluid is half rho V square, must be equal to, at S2 pressure is P naught plus kinetic energy is half rho multiplied by root 2gh whole square. So from this relation, we'll get the value of pressure difference P minus P naught, which is equals to rho gh plus rho gh. Here we can substitute, when we substitute the value of V over here, this gives us B2 power 4 by R2 power 4. So this is the pressure difference between this element pressure and the atmospheric pressure. Now we can see the pressure over here will exert a force dF on this elemental strip in normal direction, of which vertical component will get cancelled out and horizontal component will be added up. So if this angle is theta, we can consider this angle as theta, and here we can write the net force acting on this tube will be dF sin theta integration. So we can calculate the total horizontal force on tube is, this force we can write as integration of df sine theta. And if we calculate the value of df, it will be pressure difference multiplied by the area of this element. So this P minus P naught multiplied by, if its radius is r, we can consider it 2 pi small r multiplied by the width. As it's along the axis, width is dx, this will be taken as dx by cos theta. So this will be dx by cos theta multiplied by sine theta. And here x we integrate from 0 to the total length of the tube. But rather than integrating it in dx, you can see the value of dx tan theta, the sine theta by cos theta is tan theta. So dx tan theta will be the elemental increase in radius we are getting. So we can write this value as integration of P minus P naught multiplied by 2 pi r, and dx tan theta we can write as dr, and the limits of a radius from one point to another we can change from A to B. So if we calculate this value of force, this you can see P minus P naught will substitute from here, which is rho g h 1 minus b to power 4 by r to power 4 multiplied by 2 pi r dr, and we integrate this term from A to B. We have less space, but I'll try to integrate and give the result and try to evaluate it carefully here. So this gives us, after integration, the first term we'll be getting here is rho g h pi, also can be taken as a constant, and integration of r will be r square by 2. So after substituting limits, this becomes b square minus a square. And the next term we are getting is b to power 4 by, this is r cube, when we integrate this, minus 1 by 2 r square. So this becomes plus. When we integrate this, this becomes plus. And this can be given as rho g h pi, b to power 4 is also constant, and when we substitute the limits, this will be 1 by a square minus 1 by b square, because integration of 1 by r cube will be minus 1 by 2 r square. 1 minus will be changing the sign to plus, and substituting the limits from a to b gives us this value. And in this situation, when we further simplify this result and substitute here S1 as pi a square and S2 as pi b square, on simplifying this result, the final result you'll be getting is rho g h multiplied by, this will give us S1 minus S2 whole square divided by S1. I'm leaving it as an exercise for you to evaluate and verify the result by substituting S1 as pi a square and S2 as pi b square. The final result will be this, which is the final answer for this problem.